Hi everyone, this is Ramya from Tekacho Master near MISC Medical College, Kolacheri. So today I would like to give you some information regarding how to start your role play during the different settings. Okay, so you know that there are different settings. When you get a role play card, it's always better to see the settings first. Okay, rather than looking through the task, the first thing which you have to see and understand is about the setting. Only then you can understand whether the patient is a non-case or not. Okay, so what are the different settings in a role play? That is on the screen. You can see hospital ward, community health center, private clinic, hospital emergency department, home visits, hospital outpatient department, school, general practitioner, clinic, nurse practitioner, and the last one is recovery room. So these are the settings which you usually see in OED speaking. So the first we can see about the hospital ward. Hospital ward means definitely that is a non-case. Okay, non-case in the sense the patient has been admitted 2 days back or a week ago, and sometimes the patient has undergone some surgeries or something like that. So you know the condition of a patient. So you don't want to ask the name of the patient during the role play. It's always better to ask before the role play starts, like either it can be during the 3 minutes preparation time, or else if the name is given in the role play card, you can directly start with the name of the patient. Okay, so either you can ask the name of the patient and during the preparation time, or else you can just start with a name. Okay, and make sure that you will be calling the same name throughout the speaking sessions. Okay, so how to start it? You have to greet the patient or wish the patient, isn't it? So how? It's like good morning or good evening. Usually the role play will be during exam, the role play will be happening in the evening session. So it's better to go for good evening. Okay, good evening. Good evening, Miss Rachel. Whatever it is, the name of the patient, you can just start with the name of the patient. Good morning, Miss Rachel. How are you feeling today? In that way, you could have start. And then later you can, if you can introduce, like you can say that, okay, Rachel, so my name is Mac. I will be the attending nurse on duty today. So how can I help you, Miss Rachel? So in that way, you could have start the role play and go on with that one. And when it is a community health center, it can either be a non-case or not. Okay, so if it is a non-case, you have to start like that itself. You can call the name of the patient and you can start. Or else you have to wish. Definitely wishing is necessary. Whatever be the settings, wishing is important. Okay, so you can start like how you can start. Good morning, take your seat. Okay, and then you can introduce yourself. You can say that, yeah, my name is Rachel. I'm one of the registered nurses working in this community center. So today, how can I help you? Okay, in that way you could have started the role play when it is a community health center. Now let's see what about the private clinic. The same way, that cannot be can be a non-case. Usually it won't be a non-case. If it is a non-case, definitely that will be a ward routine will be given there, or else they'll be saying about the second or third visit in this particular clinic. Only then you can understand that it is a non-case. So in a private clinic also, the first thing is you have to wish good morning, good evening, good afternoon, whatever it is. And then you have to introduce, ask them to take their seat. And you have to introduce, good morning, my name is Rachel. I'm one of the registered nurses working in this private clinic. Okay, and how can I help you today? Okay, then you can ask their name and can start accordingly. When it is an emergency department, the next thing is emergency department. When it is an emergency department, it's better to start like asking about the concerns itself, because usually in emergency department, the patient will be coming with some pain or following an accident or something like that. The situation will be emergency. So saying a lot of story in the introduction is not quite good. So either you can just start accordingly. You can wish the patient, and the main thing is that you have to focus on the tone, because definitely the patient will be with some pain. So you have to be understandable, and your tone should also be in the same way. Okay, so good morning, how can I help you? What happened to you? You seems to be quite upset. What makes you upset? In that way you could have start the role play. Okay, and later you can introduce and ask the name of the patient. So it's always better to ask the concerns first. Okay, and focus on your tone. Next one is about the home visit. When it is a home visit, that too is a non-case. Okay, non-case in the sense, you know that patient, sometimes you will be coming from the hospital where the patient had undergone a surgery, or else it will be a routine checkup, or else it can be the doctor had sent you to educate him regarding some techniques like insulin or something like that. So definitely there also, after greeting the patient, it's better to ask like, is this Mr. Rachel's home? Am I speaking to Ms. Rachel? Is this the right time to speak to you? So these kind of things is quite important when you are doing a role play at during home visit. Okay, so here the example given over there. Good morning, I'm Charlie, a community nurse working in your locality. Am I talking to Miss Alexi? Okay, so definitely the person will be replying. So how you can, I'm in the right place, talking to the right person. Nice to meet you. Okay, in that way you could have started the conversation. Again, the next one is outpatient department. There also you have to wish and introduce yourself. Hi, good morning. My name is Rachel, one of the registered nurses working in this outpatient department. So, how may I address you? And later you would like to ask about, you can ask about what would you like to discuss about today? Okay, or what would you like to discuss today? So in that way you could start your role play when you are dealing a patient in outpatient department. So the next one is school. Sometimes a school nurse, you can be a school nurse, so you will be dealing with children. There also you have to focus on the tone of your tone, because you are speaking to small children, so definitely there also you have to pay quite importance for your tone. So you can wish good morning, take your seat can be given, and you can start conversation like, I'm Miss Shirley, the school health nurse. You seem quite upset. Would you mind telling me the reason behind your worries? So in that way you could have start when it is a school. Next one is GP clinic. There also it can be a non-case or not. There also you have to wish and you have to introduce yourself. Good morning, my name is Rachel. I'm one of registered nurses working in this GP clinic. How may I address you? Then the next questions will be, okay, could you just elaborate the reason behind your visit? Okay. Or else if it is a non-case. Okay, if it is not a non-case, you can start in that way. And if it is a non-case, it's better to start like, yeah. Good morning, Miss Rachel. What happened to you today? How can I help you? Nice to see you again. In that way, you could have start the role play when it is a non-case. The next one is about the nurse practitioners. That will be going in the same way as of a GP practitioner. There also same thing can be asked, either it can be a non-case. If it is a non-case, definitely you can start accordingly, and if it is not, you can go for introducing yourself and you can ask them to ask them how you can help them. Okay, and the last one is about the recovery room. There also the patient may be recovering from an aesthetic effect and may or may not be oriented, so we need to start according to the role play card. Sometimes these informations will be given in the role play as such. So you have to see the role play card and understand what is the situation, whether the patient is worried about something or whether the patient is disoriented. All these things has to be noted, and later only you have to start it accordingly. So there also you can greet the patient, introduce yourself, and again you need to ask him whether he can remember his name. Okay, and you need to explain the situation. What is his current situation he is undergoing? So these kind of things is quite important when it is a recovery room. You cannot just start the role play and rush through the task. It's better to pause, think about the situation, and you have to start accordingly. Okay, so you have to ask him whether he can remember his name, and you need to explain the situation, what surgery he has undergone, when he will be moved to the ward. All these things can be explained. Okay.